Affirmation 5. I will develop leaders.
Hello, friends. To many people, the term servant leader is a contradiction. Similarly, the title woman leader is also a contradiction and a paradox to some people. If you are a servant, you cannot be a leader. If you are a leader, you cannot be a servant. And woman leader is a distant idea for many. Well, I'm not a feminist, but I'm committed to women empowerment, helping women to see as God sees them. Now, everyone is accountable to God for the gifts and abilities and opportunities God has given them. And my Bible in Romans 14:12, it says, so then each of us will give an account of ourselves to God. So I was affirmed and I was reminded on encouraging women to follow the call of God in their life. Now, during my faith journey, I faced rejection and humiliation by some women leaders. On the other hand, when I helped a particular woman to come out of her depression, brought her up to a national platform, but soon she started avoiding me. You know, she kind of felt threatened and insecure. Another woman I gave hand and provided exposure and a wider opportunity for service, she ignored me when she took charge in another organization. And she did not want to partner with me. So it had been a challenge. You know, I wished they worked with me, they helped me, and they recognized me. But then God reminded me that mentoring is to help a woman to be what God wants her to be and to do what God wants her to do. What a challenge. The women in whom I invested time and energy, some other organizations took them away. You know, at such time, the Lord again said that I'm just one of the instruments in their life. Why should I feel hurt? And I came to a point where I said, Lord, I will equip women you bring into my life and release them for your service. After all, I am building God's kingdom and not my own empire. From then on, the Lord has been giving me wonderful women to work with, and my heart delights in them when they take up responsibilities of leadership in the churches. I thank God for Johnny, my husband, who introduced me to MentorLink. And he became my mentor and helped me to be effective mentor in the ministry.
God called me into the ministry on September 29, 1994. Since that time, I have served God in this continent. And I have witnessed that the biggest need of the African church is the need of a biblical and spiritual leadership, which truly stands for the name of Jesus, whatever the cost. And therefore, I chose to give my testimony on the Leaders' Covenant number 5. The Church of Christ stands or falls on its leadership. Leadership is critical for the growth and stability of the church. Leaders' Covenant number 5 is framed in a very challenging way. This Leaders' Covenant number 5 does not say, I will train leaders. It says, I will develop leaders. In fact, folks, brothers and sisters, whenever the idea of training is raised up, people see and think primarily of the transfer of a content. But developing leaders entails giving them whatever it takes, practically, existentially, and theoretically, to become whatever God wants them to become. In training, you pour a content in. In developing, you help people blossom. You remove the covering to bring out the real thing that was covered. You bring out the real life. You create a trusted relationship. Training leaders entails transferring the content of what is studied, and most of the time, it remains at that level. Developing leaders entails giving one's full life as a means to shape another life. I'm committing myself to develop leaders because developing leaders was one of the top priorities of our Lord Jesus Christ. And I hope you and I can be engaged in that process. Leaders who lead like Jesus, walk like Jesus, speak like Jesus, serve like Jesus, and who take the lead to develop leaders like Jesus did. May God bless all of us and give us grace to be able to face the challenge and to succeed in it for his own glory. Amen.
One of Jesus' top priorities was to develop leaders. He did not mass produce leaders, but intentionally focused on a small number of them. I affirm that developing leaders, as Jesus did, calls me to build close, personal relationships with promising men and women and to invest time in mentoring them. I affirm that the heart cry from many younger leaders around the world is for a spiritual mentor. I also acknowledge my calling to equip saints for ministry and to release them to serve as the Holy Spirit directs. I am aware that many leaders ignore this priority. I ask for grace and insight to intentionally equip saints and strengthen the hearts and lives of younger leaders. What motivates me about Jesus' priority to develop leaders? As I look around, which leaders do I know who seek to develop younger leaders? How are churches doing in equipping saints for works of ministry? Why is this? What could be my next best steps for mentoring younger leaders? Who do I know who could complement me or help me in developing leaders?